Hello, Coyotes. President Thompson here with an update from Kansas Wesleyan. This week begins a process that our administration has been working toward for months, the return of our students to Salina. By now, you're no doubt aware of the Kansas Department of Health and Environment's quarantine restrictions. When people come to Kansas from states on the KDHE list, they must quarantine for 2 weeks. As we film, Arizona and Florida remain listed. Approximately 30 students will arrive this week and be quarantined at the Hilton Garden Inn on 9th Street. We recognize this will not be enjoyable, but those under quarantine will not be restricted to their rooms. Some socially distanced events will be possible outside, with restrictions observed, and various departments on campus are already planning these events to make sure that those students have as enjoyable experience as possible. We all have a responsibility to each other, but at the same time, we recognize that none of you signed up for this when you began your college education. Please know that we understand that and are working to normalize this experience as much as possible. As we film this, Texas and California are not on the quarantine list. However, we are encouraging students from those states who are living off campus or have an off-campus house available to them to consider returning early if possible. Our goal from the start has been to best serve our students in whatever forms that may take. We're prepared to do this by minimizing disruptions in class time and communicating regularly as the semester gets underway. Now I'd like to turn things over to my colleague, Dr. Lonnie Booker. Among his many duties on campus, Dr. Booker serves as the campus emergency manager and is a key part of our COVID-19 task force. Dr. Booker?
Thank you, Dr. Thompson. Our task force and the mitigation subcommittee has met numerous times over the past few months to prepare for this moment. I also continue to meet with county representatives on a regular basis to get the latest information to aid in our planning. Our task force wants to let students know what to expect. We want to make you aware, not fearful. You will see drastically increased signage throughout the campus, reminding you and your fellow Coyotes about social distancing and mask wearing. Our hope is that this will increase compliance, and so far, we've seen that to be the case. Currently, policies say that masks required indoors, public spaces, including classrooms, and we've added standard language to all syllabus to help turn this into a formal policy. Discipline is not our primary or preferred method, but it is possible if a student continuously refuses to wear a mask in required areas. Speaking of classrooms, you may encounter assigned seating in some of your courses. This will help in the contact tracing process, which will protect not only our campus community, but Salina community as a whole. All classrooms are being evaluated for social distances requirements as well. The university is also requiring all students to participate in a COVID course on Canvas that will cover safety and policy procedures surrounding the virus. We believe education is a key part of our plan. We expect all individuals who come to campus to help protect the health of our faculty, staff, and students. We're a family at Kansas Wesleyan, and in this time, we need to come together to help protect the health of our fellow Coyotes.
Thank you, Dr. Booker. I also want to announce that out of an abundance of caution, we have canceled all upcoming outside events on our campus. Campus-sponsored events are being continuously evaluated as well. As we close, I want to be forthright with everyone watching. The plans we put into place are designed to limit the risk of exposure, but we can't entirely eliminate the possibility. There's some risk inherent in students returning to campus. We acknowledge that. As a university, we have taken many steps to protect everyone associated with KWU. These range from face coverings to face shields, from education to signage, to increased disinfection. We believe we've taken every precaution we can while still having face-to-face courses, which our students overwhelmingly want. Should a student or their family be uncomfortable with our plan and wish to switch to online courses, we'll respect that, and it may be an option depending on one's academic program. We're thrilled at the positive response that so many of you have shared and your excitement to return to Salina and to campus. Please know that we're just as excited, and we can't wait to see each and every one of you soon. Thank you, and go Yotes!